When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by.
Yeah. I haven't got many.
Everyone apart from our important five people at the front here would like to please take their seats. Now we're starting our ceremony today with a tradition where the bride is brought to the marriage ceremony by someone who plays a special part in her life. And on this special day, this honour has fallen to Pete. The relationship between a father and a daughter is a very special one, and never more so than on her wedding day. So can I ask you, Pete, do you bring your daughter Lauren here today with love and happiness to be married to Tom?
I do.
That's lovely, thank you very much. You may wish to shake his hand. You might wish him luck, I'm not quite sure. Maybe give Lauren a kiss as well. Marriage in this country is the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. I'm now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you are free to marry. You'll then be making a formal and legal contract with each other, and you do this by repeating a declaration after me. And traditionally, in marriage law, Lauren would be really pleased to hear that Tom goes first. So, Tom, if you'd like to repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Thomas Parkin.
Why I, Thomas Parkin.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Lauren Inkpen.
To Lauren Inkpen.
And Lauren, your turn if you'd like to repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That's it, right?
I struggle with that.
Now we go to one syllable word.
Solemnly.
Perfect. That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
What?
That's right. Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Lauren Inkpen.
Why I, Lauren Inkpen.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
You're doing all right. To Thomas Parkin.
To Thomas.
Registrars always come equipped with tissues. There you go.
You don't look at me.
That's not a good way to start a marriage, but just saying. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. Has no beginning and it has no end. It symbolises unending and everlasting love and is a sign of the lifelong promise that you are making to each other today. So, someone heard me say rings, which I assume is a mat. So Matt, if you would like to just come forward
and
lay
the box. So if you'd like to open the box that's got Lauren's ring in it.
I need it.
That's great.
50-50 chance.
It is indeed.
It's usually the smaller one.
Yeah.
So if you'd like to open the box, and Tom, if you would like to take Lauren's ring. That's lovely. If you just take one step back, and that's fantastic. And if you'd like to pop the ring on Lauren's chosen finger, the third one's left hand, that's halfway down. That's lovely. And if you stay after me, exactly as you are now. Lauren, I give you this ring.
Lauren, I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love and commitment.
Of my love and commitment.
And as a pledge of our marriage.
And as a pledge of our marriage.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And I promise to love.
And I promise to love.
Respect.
Respect.
And cherish you always.
And cherish you always.
That's lovely. Do you want to slide that all the way down? Is it good? Oh, it's a perfect fit. Look at that. That's great. That's fantastic.
Well.
That's not coming off. Okay, so Matt, if you would like to take a few steps forward, and Lauren, if you would like to take Tom's ring. Thank you. You take a seat, Matt. Thank you very much. And if you would like to pop that halfway down Tom's chosen finger.
You can go on.
And perfectly placed. And if you'd like to repeat after me, she's saying to Tom. Tom, I give you this ring.
Tom, I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love and commitment.
Of my love and commitment.
And as a pledge.
And as a pledge.
Of our marriage.
Of our marriage.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And I promise to love.
And I promise to love.
Respect.
Respect.
And cherish you always.
And cherish you always.
Fantastic. And if you'd like to slide that down, is that an equally good fit? That's not coming off either, is it? Now, our bride and groom have also chosen some additional promises to say to each other. Yes, you did. So if you'd like to face each other again and stuff, maybe that. I nearly said it's like you've done this before. It's not the right thing to say.
Have you?
I've never had a bride say that before either. Anyway, Tom, if you'd like to repeat after me, obviously saying to Lauren, I promise to give you.
I promise to give you
my love and friendship.
My love and friendship.
To support and comfort you.
To support and comfort you.
To care for you.
To care for you.
With love and patience.
With love and patience.
To respect and cherish you.
Sorry, I didn't hear that.
To respect and cherish you.
To respect and cherish you.
And to be faithful always.
And to be faithful always.
These promises.
These promises.
I make to you.
I make to you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
And Lauren, if you'd like to repeat after me, obviously saying to Tom, I promise to give you.
I promise to give you.
My love and friendship.
My love and friendship.
To support and comfort you.
To support and comfort you.
To care for you.
To care for you.
With love and patience.
With love and patience.
To respect and cherish you.
To respect and cherish you.
And to be faithful always.
And to be faithful always.
These promises.
These promises.
I make to you. You're nearly there. You're nearly there.
What did you say?
These promises I make to you.
These promises I make to you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
That's it. Thank you very much. So you're now in room tissue. Are you right?
Yeah? Cheers.
Let's come from the side. So we'll wait for your eyes to be dabbed. You still look amazing. So you've now made the declarations required by law in the presence of our legal registrar, Joan, your witnesses, your family, and your guests, committing yourselves to this marriage and to this new phase in your lives together. May the rings that you wear be a constant reminder of the promises you have made today. And so, having made a binding contract of marriage, it's now my pleasure and privilege to pronounce that you are now husband and wife, and it's traditional to seal the marriage contract with a kiss amidst loads of applause. stand. And it gives me great pleasure to introduce the new Mr. and Mrs. Polkin.
To coat the one you love to wear, so I keep feeling close to what's beyond compare. The moments we can know, you catch me in your eyes, that beauty on my pillow that holds me in the night. In my mouth when I used to be afraid of the words, but with you I've learned just to let it out. Now my heart is ready to burst, 'cause I feel like I'm ready for love. And I
our bride and groom, the new Mr. and Mrs. Parkin.
First one I've got to talk about is Lauren. She is she is truly amazing, and today and always is beautiful. She means so much to me, and I every day I love her more and more, and today has just been so special. Being able to marry the person who I love and the person who is my best friend.
Are you all right about that? They actually think they're my best friends. It's all right, babes.
So, Lauren, I just want to say a massive thank you for... First of all, being an amazing wife to me now. You are truly amazing. You are an amazing, you're an amazing mum to our kids. I wouldn't be able to go day to day without you. You are truly amazing. So I just want to say thank you. So everyone, I would like to raise a glass. So cheers to Lauren.
Oh, cheers myself.
My husband, you are the most incredible, incredible, incredible dad to Sophie, Jacob, our other child that we have. To Jacob, to watch you sit there and you teach him how to build flat back furniture and how to do gardening. And you do know that he doesn't actually care, don't you?
He knows.
He doesn't like it. Maybe one day he'll be out on the golf course. But to see that, it absolutely warms my heart. You are an incredible dad. You're just my person. There's no other way to say it, really. I just love you. And you get me in every single way. So that dream that I had with the turban on my head, getting out of the bath as a little girl, it was a fairy tale, really, and it's come true, and it was better than I ever imagined.
There are days I wake up and I pinch myself. You're with me, not someone else. And I'm scared, yeah, I'm still scared. That is all a dream. 'Cause you still look perfect as days go by. Even the worst ones, you make me smile. I'd stop the world if it gave us time.
Cause when you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably never loved someone like I do. You probably never loved someone like I do. When you say you love the way I make you feel, everything becomes so real. Don't be scared, no, don't be scared. Cause you're all I need. And you still look perfect as days go by. Even the worst ones, you make me smile. I'd stop the world if it gave us time. Cause when you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably never loved someone like I do. You probably never loved someone like I do. When you love someone, you open up your heart. When you love someone, you make room. If you love someone and you're not afraid to lose them, you probably never love someone like I do. You probably never love someone like I do. You probably never love someone. We'll be right back.